back to my channel. Today we're doing something extremely fun. Also, you're very close to my face.
Hello.
You're seeing me in probably one of my most natural states, and that is hair in some form of a messy bun with makeup. So like, I'm partially accomplished, but like the rest of me is just kind of a hot mess. Today we're doing something that I'm absolutely obsessed with, and that is shelf styling. Now, I do not profess to be an expert by any means at all whatsoever. I've just found a couple of tips and tricks that work really well for me whenever I'm styling. So I figured this thing was looking a little sad. I mean, it's not looking sad anymore because I fixed it, but whatever. So why not take you guys along with me and I'll show you how I style shelves in my home. So without further ado, let's just jump right on into it. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is shop your home. Now, this happens to be really easy for me because I'm a little bit of a hoarder. Just like a tiny bit of a hoarder. I have like just tchotchkes. I have stuff everywhere. So putting something together like this isn't too difficult for me, but don't feel like you have to go out to a store to buy new stuff to style a shelf. You can always just walk around your home and steal things from other locations because, you know, you're doing it for the gram, right? Sometimes taking a piece from one area and putting it in another area can feel like it's fresh and brand new all over again. And that, for me, is a great way to style and save money. Because then I'm reusing items, they feel fresh all over again, and I'm not spending any money. Win-win, right? Now for this particular shelving unit, because of the way that it's divided, I knew in the very beginning that I was gonna put together 6 different vignettes. There. Now, when putting these together, I wanted them to have kind of like equal weight and balance to them, so there wasn't one really, really tiny vignette and one really, really heavy one. That just didn't work out really well for this space. So in order to make sure everything was balanced, I tried to find pieces that were kind of the same width, height, those sorts of things. And if it wasn't, then I did my best to build them up so they would all balance each other out. For this, I grabbed coffee table books, a tray, and a couple of different vessels to hide all of the ugly stuff that I have to have in this cabinet. But I don't want to look at every single day. The next thing you're going to want to do is to build your color palette. For this particular cabinet, it is very dark. It's a dark kind of like a seafoamy green, and the backdrop of it, that same exact color. And so I wanted to infuse a lot more brightness into the area without just actually just throwing in a bunch of white, because I felt like that contrast would be too sharp. Instead, I opted for white, orange, and green. Now, when it comes to colors, they don't always have to be literal. For example, when incorporating the color orange, I could use something like this cute little copper mug that's supposed to be for a Moscow mule, but it's cute, so I could decorate with it. Or something like this, a mid-century modern wooden banana, which sounds quite random, but trust me, it works. See how both of these kind of come across that same orangey brown tone? And by combining two different textures, metal and wood, I'm all of a sudden adding depth and layers to my design. So when putting together all of your pieces, don't be afraid to mix and match, because even though these might seem kind of random together, when they're put into a display like this, they all come across as the same orange tone. Now, the first thing that I did when putting this whole thing together is got the boring stuff out of the way, and that's all of the practical things that I had to get done. A couple of things that we have to have in this cabinet. One is our Apple TV and our Wii, because this is where it's stored, so like I have to have it in there, otherwise we don't get to watch TV or play Wii. The second thing I have to have in here is all of the Wii remotes and games, which are not cute, do not fit with my aesthetic, so I had to find a way to hide those and make sure that they wouldn't be seen, but also be extremely accessible because kids are sometimes known for being just a little bit lazy and not super good at putting things away in a neat and tidy manner, so I wanted to be able to hide that really well. The third thing that this cabinet has to have is a downstairs diaper station. This is a mom hack for all of you moms out there or moms-to-be. Always have a diaper station downstairs because I guarantee you, you will not always want to walk upstairs to change that poopy diaper. Sometimes you are just going to want to park yourself on the couch and change your baby right where you're at. So that's something I had to have down here. Something to put diapers in, diaper cream, wipes, you know, all the baby accoutrement. But there's no guarantee that the diaper cream or the powder or the diapers are going to fit with my aesthetic. So finding a way to hide those but still keep them accessible, kind of important to me. Because this cabinet has these giant cross beams right here, I didn't necessarily want to spend a bunch of time decorating those middle shelves because they'd really just be hidden by these cross pieces, so there wasn't really any point of over decorating that space. Instead, I opted to put the Wii remotes and games into this vintage travel case to kind of hide them, but still make them really accessible for the kids to get to, and stuck that right on the middle shelf. On the opposite side, I grabbed a basket for all of the diaper changing needs stuff. It has the same visual weight as the travel case and the same color tones as well. So as you can see, I'm slowly building my palette here. And although they're not matching, they have an equal presence in the shelf. Also, I opted for a basket for this one because when you're holding a wiggling toddler and you need to do a diaper change stat, you don't have time for buttons or lifting a lid. You just need to reach in there, grab a diaper, and get on out because you've got a stinky situation on your hands. The next practical thing that I need to figure out how to cover up or blend in but not actually cover is the Wii and the Apple TV. So I grabbed this Pothos, which tends to be a low light tolerant plant because this is a lower light area, and draped it over the top of those. So now that we've gotten all the practical, boring stuff out of the way, let's get into the actual fun part, and that is building our vignettes. Using the travel case and basket for reference, I've gathered coffee table books, trays, and a bunch of vintage books to help build up my bases. The next step is to build your triangle. In this particular space, I did two right angle triangles and two equilateral triangles, maybe more isosceles, I don't know. Look at all my high school geometry coming out to play. I didn't Google that right before this video. That would be silly. So first, let's start with the right angle triangles. I have one in this corner and one in this corner to balance each other out and to make sure everything's not too matchy, but again, equal in weight. In this corner, I opted for a collection of both coffee table books and vintage books. To create that right angle that I wanted, I put the coffee table books flat and then layered a couple vintage books up on the side. So even though you can't always see them from all different angles, it definitely adds weight to that corner. And then for this bottom corner, instead of using one large book, I did a collection of vintage books that when piled together, created the same amount of weight. This is a cool hack if you are looking to build up a shelving space, but you don't have everything that's equally sized or super similar. Instead, group a bunch of items of the same kind of height together, and you'll find that you create a block just as weighty as your other pieces. Continuing to build my base, I then did my isosceles or equilateral triangles, you take your pick, but that's basically where the weight is directly at the bottom, and then it comes to a point at the top. And to kind of directly balance out the right angle triangles, I did them here and here. Again, starting with my base, up in this corner, I chose yet another coffee table book that has the same color palette that we're going with. It has those warm browns, it has a couple of creams in it, and while it didn't have any green, I already had green in that space brought in by the Pothos. And then down in this corner, to build my base, I selected this beautiful mother of pearl bamboo tray that I have been dying to use in my home somewhere. I got this in Goodwill. Can you believe that? Freaking Goodwill, coming in hot with the mid-century modern slash boho slash kind of beachy theme. I'm here for it. So now that we have our bases in each of our general vignettes, this is where the fun part comes in. It's all about building up those spaces. Now I'm sure this isn't news to you guys, but using an uneven number of items is really aesthetically pleasing. So for this upper corner, I knew that I needed to fill in the space between the vintage books and the coffee table books because there was kind of a gap right there in that corner. So I grabbed this vintage antler, a fig plant, yes, because I do have a couple of those, because sometimes in low light areas, you just can't make a plant work. And these beautiful sea glass beads. What I love about these beads is that they can drape over the books and kind of break up the lines of what we see there, blending the entire design together. So instead of seeing harsh lines, you kind of just see, again, that triangle that I was trying to create. Focusing the design and again, the weight into that corner, you can see how then it makes a nice smooth transition and that trio of items then creates the perfect triangle. Jumping on down to the vintage book corner, let's call it that, shall we? I took a handful of the books and dropped them on their sides. Again, to pull in that green and that terracotta orange that I like so much, I then grabbed this Dracaena Janet Craig in a gorgeous terracotta pot and then this funky little cloche with an air plant in it. Again, this was a Goodwill find and y'all, I cannot tell you how much I love thrift shopping because you get to find really random stuff like this. This is pretty definitive of how I design spaces. I like to take things that could be normal and just make them a little bit funky. So grouping these all together, again, you can see how that nice, easy triangle is formed to balance out the one we have in the upper corner. Next, moving on to the Apple TV Wii corner. To make it feel like it was more purposeful, like, yeah, they're supposed to be here. They're a part of the decor, they're cute, right? They're not. And because I already have that plant there kind of draping over the top of the Apple TV, all I needed to do was add one more element to complete my little trio triangle of sorts. So I opted for this mid-century modern piece of fruit because again, it pulls in that orange that I like to contrast with the white that we see on the pot and the green of the leaves and also matches some of the orange and warm brown tones that we see on the spine of the book. Now finally down onto our last corner. This one was probably the most fun for me to put together only because I was so freaking excited about using this tray, finally. Can you believe it's been sitting in a closet for like 3 months? What is wrong with me? I don't know. Grabbing yet another vintage book and layering it down to kind of break up all of that white that you see on the tray, I take a pair of vintage opera glasses. With the leather handles, that these really do draw in that warm orangey-brown tone that you can see is pretty thematic for this space. I also happen to have another Pothos because y'all know me and my plants, I have quite a few of them, and because this is a low-light area, again, I decided to stick a more low light tolerant plant. I like how this one's kind of lopsided too, because it really does help to build that triangle that I want. And then the last element that I put in here is I believe this one's a candy dish. So it's a vintage silver candy dish that I actually purchased for our wedding to use for centerpieces, and layered up more of those mid-century modern wooden fruits, just like the one that we have up here. Not only does this help to bring in that orange tone, but it helps to tie in the overall design. So now we have fruit up here, fruit down there, pothos up here, pothos down there. So while they look different, it has a similar theme to them. See where I'm going with this? In the same manner, we have the vintage books up here and the vintage books down there. A spiky plant here and a spiky plant there. So even though everything seems kind of mismatched and hodgepodge, using things that have the same weight and the same general shape ended up creating a polished look. And I still got to keep all of the practical things that I have to have in this cabinet, whether I like it or not. Also, potty training is coming soon. So let's start praying now, okay? Because this basket may be obsolete pretty soon. But that means we're potty training. Great. So that's all we have for today, folks. Thank you so much for stopping by. Hopefully you found today's video helpful. I know you guys have been asking for a lot more home decor related videos, so hopefully this inspires some of you to get in your house and just get a little crazy, all right? Just a little bit. And don't be afraid to like spend a lot of time on this. I will admit that I started working on this at like 9:30 this morning, okay? And it is now almost 1 o'clock. Now, bear in mind, of course, I was doing most of it with a toddler, but like, it takes time to pull a lot of this off. And sometimes you have to go back around your house and do a little bit more shopping to make sure you have the correct pieces. But when keeping in the same color scheme and having a few of the same thematic elements, you'll see that it's quite easy to tie your entire shelving unit together. And until next week, bye guys.